Hi again. This is Joellen, and we have Sarah and Nathan, and we are here with Greenway because they've been nominated for Green Business of the Year by the business community, the Arcata Chamber of Commerce. We're announcing the winners in February 25th to be exact, at the Arcata Community Center. But until then, we want to educate the business community and the community at large on what these different nominees are up to and doing and contributing to the community. So we have invited Sarah Dimitroff, who is the project manager here at Greenway, as well as Nathan Sanger, an environmental civil engineer, and they're going to share with us about Greenway. So maybe Sarah, you would want to begin with what is Greenway?
Sure, yeah. So Greenway is a project management and design firm, and we've been in business here in Arcata for about 8.5 years. And our purpose is to solve community challenges. So we work with local governments, with private business owners, with foundations, with local school districts, pretty much anybody that is, looking to move some project forward. If it, it can include things like strategic planning efforts, or maybe they want to build a new building, or maybe they want to help control their operating costs, and they want to make their buildings more environmentally efficient and friendly, or their service offerings more friendly. And so we have a whole team of about 14 different staff members who will work with you through various stages of your project to help bring your sustainable goals to the forefront of your business and into your business practices.
Okay, and when do you come into play, Nathan?
Hopefully early and often. I do a lot of work in various capacities, and one thing at Greenway that I also wanted to mention is that our mission really is driven by, what people call the triple bottom line. We want to make sure that all the projects that we do that Sarah mentioned, bring value and are good for not only the environment, but also, the community, and also be, something that's financially viable for everyone that comes to us.
What would you say you specialize in, or why do people come to you, Sarah?
Well, I think one of the things that makes Greenway stand apart from the rest, there's a lot of different consulting firms that do similar things to what we do. But oftentimes, you need to come to them with, have already dollars in hands, and you already have a design, and they'll put it together for you. And what Greenway is really good at doing is we have what's called a discovery process, and we work very intimately with all of our clients to really understand what their needs are at a very early stage and a very intimate stage. So we have several meetings, we have several means of getting to know distinctly what they need. And sometimes, that means for clients they may need something very different than what they thought they needed to begin with. And also through the discovery process, a lot of times people don't, especially in our small community, people don't actually have funding. And so we can work with them and help find funding for them. And then we walk them through the entire process, so we can do all the things that a traditional firm like ours can do. We can do planning, we can do permitting, engineering, energy services, all those, and then we can also act as a client's representative, do construction management, and basically go from no project to a completed project. That's, I think, what kind of sets us apart.
And because you were nominated for Green Business of the Year, are there certain sustainable or green practices that people are wanting more these days, or you're introducing to them more these days?
Yeah, I think so. I think, there's probably several reasons. I mean, we definitely offer energy management services, so we'll look at your building and help you make it more efficient. We'll add renewable energy, solar, is one area that we work in, sort of facility management. You can kind of translate that to infrastructure on a larger scale. So when we're working with the cities, like City of Arcata, City of Eureka, City of Fortuna, on different pieces of infrastructure that they have to help make their operations more efficient. Aside from energy, we have an outdoor resource arm that's working on sea level rise and adaptation and planning. What other areas can we?
I think one of the real cutting edge areas that we're being asked a lot of is the zero net energy. Basically, mm-hmm. If your project that you're putting together, if it produces more or equal energy to what it consumes on site, people are really excited about that, and there's a lot of legislation coming down the line that's going to require most buildings to be like that in the future. So that's definitely something that a lot of people are asking about. And we can do that in many ways. We can do that by a really efficient building so that it takes very little energy. So, you know, LED lighting or just using natural lighting, but also reduced energy requirements for, like, you know, for heating by doing passive heating. And then, of course, things that people are more well-versed in, like photovoltaics, solar hot water, stuff like that. So I think that's mm-hmm. one of the things that's really exciting and people are talking a lot about.
And also, you know, Nate kind of mentioned earlier, bringing financing to these projects is an area where we work with local banks, we work with economic development organizations, you know, we seek out grants, and we kind of can help a client shape a project so that they're most eligible for these other types of funds that are out there. And so that's why it's really important to us early on to find out what your goals are and know them very, very intimately so that we can help you craft your project scope and, but on a broader level, a story, right? You want to tell a better story about how sustainable your business can be and the way that it fits into a niche or the broader community, and you know, kind of connecting all the pieces between you know, idea, finance, planning, and development, and ultimately implementation. So we kind of, not many firms out there today kind of combine all of those pieces, right? Some they all specialize, right? There are banks, there are engineering firms, there are planning firms, and then you kind of, the client has to sort of stitch all those pieces together, potentially, but we really see the need to keep, you know, a coherent thought through all of those processes, and that's, you know, probably the greatest advantage that we bring, and we prioritize sustainability in all of our work, and so that's also on the forefront of, you know, the our approach to projects.
Wow, this is been enlightening. I really don't know to what extent and how it all you do it all, mm-hmm. and people can stay in house for all of that and have someone understand the whole scope of what they're wanting to do. So thank you so much for your time and for educating the viewers, and I'm sure you've reached a lot of people and enlightened them as well. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So thank you very much, Nathan and Sarah.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations on the nominee.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.